This is Big Zion Missionary Baptist Church, 521 West 65th Street, 773-484-6688, where Reverend Antonio M. Grafton Jr. is the pastor. Look, we're in our 101st year anniversary. Come join us, 101st year anniversary. Bless you. Don't touch that now. Bless all of the ministries here, Lord.
We just ask that you have your way, Lord. We ask, Lord, that this entire place just be filled with your spirit today. We praise you, Lord. You've been so good. We can't thank you enough, Lord, for all the blessings you've bestowed upon us all. We do ask, Lord, that you would continue to have mercy on us, that you would continue, Lord, to have mercy on those that are less fortunate than us, the poor, the hungry, the sick, the shut-in, the bereaved. We all need you, Lord, and we know, Lord, that you're able to meet all the needs that we have. So, Lord, we will continue to praise you. We will continue to worship you. We will continue to give you the glory you so rightfully deserve. And it is in the mighty, majestic name of Jesus that we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Cheryl Lewis.
Cheryl Johnson to introduce our worship leader.
Yeah. He told him to speak comfortable to Jerusalem and cry to her to let her know that her warfare is accomplished. Yeah. And that her iniquity is pardoned. For she has received of the Lord hand double for her sin. The prophet Jeremiah had prophesied that Israel would go into Babylon captivity for 7 years. Then the Lord was going to set them free. God is no shorter than his word. If he speak it, it'll come to pass. First, we want to look at here the promise of deliverance. Yes. You see, first of all, that God had promised them that when the 70 years was going to pass, yeah, that he was going to deliver them. That's why we need to wait on the Lord. Yeah. Am I right about it? Yeah. You know, blessing delayed is not blessing denied. When God said it's going to come to pass, yes. Joshua, before in his last speech to the children of Israel, he said, not one thing that God had promised that he didn't bring to pass. Boy, that's something to tell young folks about. Oh, if you just sit back and the old folks and tell the young folks, listen, my little sister, my little brother, everything that God said, he has brought it to pass. Not one thing has failed. He promised that he was going to deliver him, and he did deliver him. Just wait on the Lord. Not only was he going to free them, which we see in verse 1 through 10, but in verse 11, he would take care of them. It's one thing to be delivered, but it's another thing to be taken care of after you've been delivered. One thing to have a child and bring them into the world. But it's another thing to take care of the child. Look what he says. He shall feed them like a shepherd. He shall gather them like a lamb with his arm and carry them in his bosom gently, leading those that are young. God, the Lord is our shepherd. Yes. David said, we shall not want. So not only will he deliver us, but he has the power to take care of us. What kind of God that would be to set us free from our sin? And then just left her alone. But not only has he set us free, but is able to keep us in the midst of trial and tribulation. He's able to sustain us through the pitfalls of life. He'll take care of us. Secondly, we want to look at the power of his greatness. The Jews were few in numbers. Only the remnant was facing a long, difficult journey back to Palestine. The victories of the Assyrian, the Babylonian, and the Persian made it look as though their false god of the Gentile was stronger than the God of Israel. Sometimes when we talk about Moses and Pharaoh, amen, we make Moses and Pharaoh the center by argument. But it wasn't about Moses and Pharaoh. It was a God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob versus the Babylonian God. Help me, Holy Ghost. Moses was just an instrument. So it's not about us preachers, it's about Christ. You know that about it? You know, we black folks, we black Christians, we have our favorite preacher. Am I right? You ought to go and read Corinthians. Paul said, one water, one plan, on God, give increase. One that planted and the one that watered is the same. If one just planted, nothing gonna happen. And if one try to water and nothing had been planted, still ain't nothing gonna happen. And they both, one watered, one planted, and still nothing gonna happen. Only God. Give the increase. So we bless the name of our God. So Isaiah wanted them to know that the God of Israel was the great and mighty God. When we behold the greatness of God, then we will see everything else in its proper perspective. When we think about the greatness of God, God is greater than anything on earth, anything in heaven. Creation shows his wisdom, his power. He is greater than any nation and any other nation God. He founded the earth, and he sits on the throne of heaven. Nothing is equal to our God. And no one is greater than our God. I am the first and the last. I am the Almighty One. Told Moses, said, now, when you go down to Egypt and tell the children of Israel that you come to deliver, well, who should I tell to send me? You tell them, I am. That I am. I always was. I always will be. I know all night. Before everything was, I existed. And after everything is, I'll still be there. Help me, Jesus. So, my brothers and sisters, the next time you're tempted to think that the world is bigger than God, remember that the nations are nothing but a drop in the bucket. As grasshoppers. Oh, if you feel so small that you wonder if God really cares about you personally, remember that he knows every star. Every hair on your head is numbered. And he knows your name as well. That's personal. Yeah. He knows your name. He knows your voice. All of us can be praying right now. Not only in Big Zion, but all the churches of every Christian across the country. But God still knows our voice. What an awesome God that we serve. He is awesome. Omnipotent. stars can heal your broken heart. You want to be renewed, you think about it. See, when you start thinking about the goodness of God, you, your spirit and your faith will be renewed. Sometimes you get a little down and out. Problems in life. So we need to just stop sometimes and think about the goodness of God. We need to trust God regardless of your circumstances. Is anything too hard for God?
No, sir.
Nothing is too hard.
That's right.
Listen, I won't serve a God that could do something and couldn't do the other. I wouldn't serve a God that knew something and didn't know all everything. I wouldn't serve a God that would be at Big Zion and not at New Progressive. He's omnipresent. All knowing. Omnipotent. Not some power. Circumstances as those nasty things that you see when you get your eyes off of God. Peter was doing well. Lord, if that's you, lead me to come. Jesus spoke one word. So walking on water, doing the impossible. Do you know as long as you keep your eyes on Jesus, you can walk up on your troubles? You can walk up on top of your circumstances. He was doing well. So he took his eyes off Jesus and started looking at his circumstances. And he began to sink. We all have to grow in faith. All our faith has to be renewed. But you know, when you fall, Jesus is not like us. Amen?
Amen.
We fall. Folks step on you when you fall. They'll pour water on a drowning man. But when Peter, you know, folks will want to see your failures. It's amazing that Christian folks, right next to you, preachers want to see other preachers fail. Choirs want to see other choirs fail. Churches want to see other churches fail, thinking that the members want to leave there and come to their church. They take glory when they see you downfall. But Jesus saw him fall. About to sing. He didn't pray one of them deacons' prayer. Father, I stretch my hand to you. He just said, save me! Tell you, when you're serious about praying, you got time to do it.
That's right. That's right.
Go right to the point. small and very far away. But if by faith you look at your circumstances through God, He will draw near and reveal His greatness to you. I'm almost finished. So, prophet began to ask this question to the children of Israel. Why say thou, O Jacob, and speakest, O Israel? Why did you say that God's ways is hid from you, and that His judgment has passed over you? These are words of despair because of Israel's present condition. Israel had suffered in exile for so long that they thought that there was no way for their escape. Some of us have been in situation for so long until we don't feel that there is no help for us. I want to let you know that if you are saved, God has His eyes on you. Am I right about it? His eyes is upon the righteous. And I know that He will make a way. Help me, Holy Ghost. So the prophet goes on and said, God knows about your difficulties. God knows about your problems. God knows what you are going through. What kind of father he would be if he turned his back on his children. If you belong to Him, He's able to quieten your storm. If you don't quiet your storm, there's a lesson that He wants to teach you as you go through your storm. But if you find yourself in the midst of a storm, instead of weeping and complaining, just fall on your knees and say, Lord, teach me as I go through the valley of the shadow of death. Teach me why I'm going through this situation. I make my eyes. When you bring me through, because I know that it weeping may endure for a night. I know joy gonna come in the morning. So now I know I want you to show me, Lord. God is our answer. But He heals us spiritually. Yeah. Am I right about it? Yeah. You know, that's one thing about Christians. When we accept Christ, that was a blues song. It's a How Can We Lose? Which is still for you. How can we lose with one that loves us unconditionally? Yeah. If He keep you here, it's a blessing. Yeah. But He ain't keep you here to look cute. Yeah. He keep you here to serve. Yeah. If you live, it's all right. Yeah. But if you die, it's still gay. Yeah. Christ came for absent from the body. Yeah. The special of the Lord. Yeah. You cannot lose being a Christian. Close. notice here the promise of renewal.
All right.
You know, it seemed like the prophet was just, as he was penning this, as he was just looking in the eyes of the Israelites.
Yeah.
He said, "Has thou not known? Have you not read in the scripture? Have you not heard? Did anybody ever tell you about the everlasting God? The Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth." What about him? He faints not. Neither is he weary. God's power does not diminish, Isaiah 1 and 7.
He never gets tired. And he never too busy to help or listen. Somebody's not here today because they're too busy. Some person, you try to talk to them, they're too busy to listen. They don't have time to hear what you. I got my own problem. But I'm so glad. I'm so glad that his ear is attending up to my cry. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard him and delivered him. All taste and see that the Lord is good. Bless him. Oh, your God, thank you about how good he is. Your faith will be renewed when you think about where he brought you from. Your spirit will be renewed.
Well, I like this part down here.
All right.
Verse 29.
Yeah.
He give power to the faint.
Yeah.
Well, we faint. To them that don't have no might.
Yeah.
One that are weak. The Bible said he increased their strength. God is the source of our strength. Paul said, God's grace is sufficient. That's why he could joy in his tribulation and his weakness and all of that, that the power of God may rest upon him. He said, because when I'm weak, you're then I'm strong. When you feel like life is crushing you, you cannot go another step. Remember that you can call on the Lord. And if you call on him, you can get an answer. The Bible said, even in youth, shall faint and be weary. Young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up wings like eagles. They shall run and not get weary. Desire and wait upon the Lord. Wait, I said, upon the Lord. To wait means to rely on. Wait means to trust in. Wait means to believe in. I declare, he'll bring you through. I declare, he'll deliver you. And you're all right. And you're all right. And you're all right. And you're all right. Wait on the Lord, be of good courage, he shall strengthen thy heart.
The invitation to discipleship is being extended. There's one here today.
Good afternoon, Big Zion. I don't think I can go another church anniversary without thinking of Mother Valerie Odoms, who left this temporary home and went and saw her eternal life a year ago during this time. So we want to say we miss you, Valerie Ellis. We know you will be in the back working and you'll be involved with the church anniversary. So we honor her today. And I just want to remember her. And I just want to thank everybody for everything that you've done for the last 3 months. We've been working to do what we can to celebrate 101 years, because without you all, 101 years couldn't be here. It's that little step, that little extra push, that little extra donation, that little extra money, that little extra food that you all have given, that little extra time. This is why we're here. We'll celebrate 101 years. So let's go for 102, 150, let's go 200 if we can. And let's keep continuing to push, because we all say the same, we all serve the same Lord that was there yesterday. The same Lord that was there when Reverend Sharp started Big Zion, the same God that's going to be there tomorrow. So we just want to give honors and reverence to him, and I just want to continue to thank you all for all that you've done. So our grand total for our 101 year was $3,728.08. Thank you, everybody.
Amen. Thank you so much, Church. Thank you for a concerted effort. Thank you. God be the glory for all that he has done. Amen. Big Zion, don't forget this Wednesday night, we will be the guest of South Park. Is it Wednesday or Thursday?
Wednesday night.
Okay. Okay, what time?
7 o'clock.
7 o'clock. I heard Dr. Crump. 7 o'clock Wednesday night. Amen. Choir, church, let's go in full number and support that great church.
Amen.
And that great pastor.
Amen.
Amen. So we will be, yes, sir.
Today kicks off Pastor 18th anniversary.
Amen.
And even if you're not a part of Big Zion, if you know Pastor Yard Williams, come Amen. To encourage him. He'll see the dicks, and he'll see your face.
Amen.
And have a big encouragement to him. He's going well. He's coming along.
Amen.
And let's continue to pray for you.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Pastor Lee. Thank you so much, Dr. Hine. Thank you. New Progressive, thank you.
Amen.
Amen. You all bless this effort every year. And the Lord said the same. I want to continue.
Amen.
I want to continue. The Lord said the same. Yes, yes, yes. And I'm learning, I'm learning. Start on time. Hallelujah. We started at 3. Amen. Amen. Next time I'm going to New Progressive. If I don't be there by myself, hallelujah. But I think, no, that's saying something. That's really saying something. And God is pleased with that. Amen. So I thank God. I thank God for Pastor Lee and this church. He's going to come now and give us our closing remarks and our benediction with anything else. Huh? That's it? Okay. All right, he's going to come now with my closing remarks and benediction. I want to thank Reverend Sean Coleman for helping us out and our music today. Come on, let's see Pastor Lee again.
Again, we'd just like to thank Big Zion for inviting us. And thank you, New Progressive, for supporting, praying for me and coming in. Mean a lot.
Amen.
Amen. To have your members to follow you.
Amen.
Amen. So we thank God for you. Now we are getting ready. Keep us in your prayers. We will be leaving in the morning on our way to Jonesboro, Louisiana, to lay our trustee, our friend, to rest. We'll be preaching down there Tuesday morning. So just keep us in prayers.
Amen.
That the Lord will give us the strength
one in the blue dress. Amen.
For you, I know what I want to say. If you're not, if you don't have any other engagement for Saturday morning, we have a prayer breakfast, and Sister Vivian Kyle's going to be our speaker for the prayer breakfast, and men always cook, and the ladies handle the service. So I think Sister Kyle's would really appreciate it. Now, we churches, amen, we're going to have to pull together and fellowship with one another and help them. Amen. So we need to support one another. We don't have anything we need to support. Support each other. Amen. God bless you. Come on, let's go.
Big Zion. Big Zion, just a moment, Big Zion. Just a moment, you all. Big Zion, just a moment. Come on, Big Zion. I need to, I'm going to cancel Tuesday. No Bible rehearsal, no Bible study on Tuesday. Everybody meet me at South Park. I need everybody to meet me at South Park. God bless you. Wednesday, 7 o'clock. Everybody meet me there at South Park.